Forgot. I want to say something. You see, in this story, the ghost even told, and truthfully, that most people who die suffer in hell. Because very rare we have some virtuous and morally incorrupted person.
Yes, Master. Yes, Master.
And to eat meat and all that is already a sin, already sinful, and already punishable by law, universal law. I really want to plead with all the religious leaders. You must make a good example. You must be a vegan now. Then God will forgive. Otherwise, truly, you will go to hell. I mean it. Like everyone else, if you continue to eat meat, drink wine, and even just to eat meat, not drink wine, it's already sinful enough to be punished in hell for a long, 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 long time. We can put the hotline or the talk of the sister from China about hell.
徒儿可以证实师父说，吃肉会下地狱是真实的。有一天午夜打坐完毕，内在师父跟我说，你应该下地狱去学习当佛菩萨，并帮助那里的众生。内在师父用无上大力量保护等级还不够的我下了地狱，让徒儿没有任何灼伤之感或是恐惧感。地藏王菩萨带我去一处地狱，此处罪人被强迫在一个形如水车般的大黑铁轮上面拼命地快跑，如果跑得跟不上铁轮转动的速度，就会掉到下面用烈火煮着的沸腾汤锅里煮碎了。我照师父指示，念了师父传的五圣号与七戒礼物，轮上的众生因师父大力量就脱身跪在我的面前。我问他们为何会堕入这个地狱，他们说因为生前吃很多人们追捕而来的鱼和动物的肉，这些动物们被追捕的时候惊慌逃命，却无处可逃，被抓到后又被杀，放进汤锅里把肉煮烂来吃，所以我们吃了动物的肉就堕入汤锅地狱，被罚一直不断的逃跑与被煮熟。我开导他们说，吃肉的业障极为深重，大家都是不知道吃肉后果如此可怕才敢吃，并叮嘱他们以后转身一定记得要吃纯素与做好事。罪人就跟师父超生去了，但是在说话的同时又看到很多裸体的新来的吃肉罪人从上面一个接一个堕入地狱，所以经典才说地狱不会空。此时我的肉身左手背突然有一种痛感，查看之下发现我的左手袖子无形中变得很宽大，里面有好多地狱众生被装在里面救出来了。原来地狱众生也能被缩小带出来，惊讶之余思及师父与地藏王菩萨如此帮助罪苦众生，实在太慈悲伟大了，就瞬间回到地狱赞颂起两位大圣者。才刚赞颂了两三句，就听到哐当哐当的巨响，原来是附近几个地狱的铁墙都因此而崩垮了，而且地狱原本黑黑的地上涌出了纯净明亮的泉水，形成了一个莲花池，从这池子里迅速开出了好多白莲花与金莲花，莲花越变越大，光辉美丽，地狱也能生金莲花，都因我们挚爱的青海无上师与地藏王菩萨无量的大力量大功德，实在不可思议。
It's not enough that you wear the monk's or nun's robe and just, you know, every day doing some not very useful rituals, taking donations, having a comfortable church or temple to live in, and being revered by the faithful. You must turn around, be vegan. No more meat, no more animal products. Otherwise, you cannot escape hell. In my honor, in the name of God, I tell you the truth like that. Even if you feel offended, even if I risk my safety, to tell you, the leaders of religions, I have to tell you, in the name of God. it's not enough just to learn some ritual by heart and just repeat what is in the Bible or the sutra. People trust you to lead them to the righteous way. Not only you have to be vegan, you must also advise your followers, the faithful, to do the same. Must be vegan. No more killing indirectly. The poor innocent animals that God make, the animals are also God's children and shall not be destroyed. The animals are helpers of humankind. In the Bible, it even says all that. Ask the birds, they will show you. Ask the fish, they will instruct you. Ask the animals, they will tell you. They will advise you. So they are some beings to be respected, to be loved, at least to be friendly with. It's not for us to eat, to torture in such a barbarous way. And if you eat them, these torturously kill meats, you condone this practice and you are an accomplice. I am telling you as a friend, as a faithful, as a person who respects, loves God, as a person who loves human beings and animals, as a person who cries every day and night for their suffering. I'm not spending idle time talking to you like this. I must warn you that hells are awaiting you if you don't turn around now and stop eating meat of the innocent animals. We, even no priests, even ordinary people, we humans, a humane human, should never enjoy at the cost of suffering of any others. God says, thou shalt not kill. And that never fails. That law of the universe is everywhere correct and just. No one can escape that. As you sow, so shall you reap. Just because you don't see the animal suffer, just because you don't kill the animal, doesn't mean you don't partake in the sin thereof. People trust you. You must advise them to go the compassionate way, the way Jesus walked, the way the Buddha taught, the way Guru Nanak Devji showed to us, the way Prophet Muhammad, peace be on him, taught us. All the masters say the same. Lord Mahavira did not even want to eat other fruits either. And we are allowed to eat fruits and vegetables and in plenty. We are not short of food, of nutrition. We should not kill just to enjoy. This is wicked. This is against God. That's against your mission, against the rope that you are wearing, which is the holy rope, the representative of holiness, of heaven, of God. You have to live the way our masters taught us, like Lord Jesus, Lord Buddha, Lord Mahavira, Guru Nanak Devji, the Prophet Muhammad, peace be on him, the Prophet Baha'u'llah, etc., etc. I have no more tears to show you. I cannot take out my heart to show you how sincere I am and how broken it has been over and over again because of the suffering of humans and animals. The suffering of animals affects humans and thus, humans also suffer. You are the representative of heaven. You're supposed to walk the way of heaven, of compassion, of love, of benevolence, of mercy. then all that will come to you the day you leave this world, the day you discard your rope to go back to heaven. Otherwise, you go to hell. And I guarantee that. You know I mean it. And you know it is true. So you turn now. I wish you the best. In God's mercy and love. And I love you, all of you. Please, you turn. Thank you. Thank you, all of you, for helping in this mission to save the animals.
Thank you, Master.
First, save the world as well. Save humans from this bad karma. Because every time I saw them suffering on TV, I cannot help crying my heart out. Thank you, really, from my heart. God bless you.
Thank you, Master. Thank you, Master.
We love you, Master.
I really want to talk to you every day or read to you every day to refresh your practice and to encourage you to go on, yeah, continue with the hard job and to have continuous faith in God. But it's not always possible, so we do when we can, okay, huh?
Yes, Master.
I just would love to. Just that we all have work to do and also not always favorable to talk, okay, huh?
Yes, Master.
So now I wave goodbye.
Bye, Master.
Love you forever.
We love you.
Thank you to you also. That you are a good kid.
Thank you, Master.
See you next time.
God bless you.
Love you.
Love you, Master.